Hey guys, so today I want to show you how to flash Magisk or Canal SU on your phone or tablet. Now, here with me I have the Samsung Galaxy A52, but this tutorial pretty much works on any device as the instructions are pretty much universal. So, I'm going to use this device. This is going to be the device which I use, so take note of that. It's a Samsung device and also it's a custom ROM. It has the Unica ROM on it, so it's not the stock, but the instructions pretty much hold up. So as you can see, Unica, that's the ROM, and it's not on stock, but it's basically one UI, so the instructions pretty much hold up. So I wanted to just make that clear. This is not stock, this is a custom ROM, but the instructions hold up well. So now let's hop in. So now what you're going to do is to go to settings. Then you're going to scroll and scroll up into About Phone. Then in About Phone, you go to Software Information. Then you're going to look for Build Number. Now when you see Build Number, you click it until it gives you developer options. So you basically have to tap it up to, like, I believe it's 6 or 7 times, and it's going to tell you here. But since I already have the mod activated, we're just going to go into developer mode directly. So you go, you'll see it at the bottom. Click it. Now here you'll see an option called OEM unlock, and it's going to be off, but since I'm on a custom ROM, it's not there, so you're just going to have to turn it on, and it's going to factory reset your device. So that basically means it's going to delete everything, and you're going to basically have a clean device after you activate that option. Now once you do, you're going to have to flash a custom recovery. This is a pretty important step, and it has to be done specifically for your device. Like, you're going to have to flash the custom recovery based on your device. Like, you can't flash an A52 recovery on an A23 phone. So you're going to have to look for that, and I'm going to link a video which I did going into detail on how to flash your custom recovery on your device. So I'll link it here. You're going to see a pop-up on your screen somewhere on the right. So you can go ahead and watch that, and it's going to be in-depth and it's going to help you. But in this case, I already have the custom recovery, and I'm just going to boot into that. Let me show you real quick how I do that. So you're going to restart. And as you can see, I'm connected, so you're supposed to hold the power button and the volume up button. Then when that warning pops up, you're going to release the power button. Then you're going to just hold the volume up button. Then it's going to take you to the custom recovery you installed. For me, it's the Orange Fox. So you're just going to boot into that and just focus here. So yeah, this is the Orange Fox recovery, and it looks like that. It's pretty clean. So now what you're going to do, when you click this button here, you're going to see that your storage is encrypted. So what you're supposed to do is, you're supposed to have actually, this step, it doesn't matter if it's encrypted or not. So what you're going to do is going to go back, and you're just going to flash the Magisk or the Canal SU mod. It doesn't matter if it's encrypted, but the only issue is you cannot access, like, the storage and do it, like, you and basically just flash it from here. Some devices do not allow the storage to be accessible when it's encrypted. So what you're going to do is you're going to go to ADB and sideload. You can just wipe the Dalvi cache and the cache. So now what you're going to do is you're going to flash the Magisk or the Canal SU using ADB. This is what you're going to use. So you're going to click Start Sideload. Now I'm going to hop on the laptop and continue from there. But please note, you're going to use this to avoid, like, any problems. Like, maybe you're not seeing the file when you try to access it, and this is just a much simpler step. So now let's hop on the laptop and I'll continue from there. Now I'm on the laptop, and these are my A52 files. Now here I have Magisk, which is this .apk file, and I also have the you know, you can see it. Oh, here it is. This is the Ascendia Kernel, which has the Kernel SU in it. So I'm just going to use this. This is a kernel, but it's pretty much the same thing with the Kernel SU. So these are the files I need. But as you notice, sorry for that. But as you can notice, this is an APK file and this is a zip file. Now I'm going to show you a pretty neat trick. This is the Magisk APK file. So what you're going to do is you're going to rename it. And you're going to basically change the .apk to a .zip file. Now it's going to give you a warning that it's going to be unusable, but Magisk works this way that you can just change the APK to be a .zip and it's going to be perfectly fine. So I'm just going to click yes. And as you can see now, the Magisk.apk is now a zip file and both are zip files, so you can just sideload pretty easily. Now, like I said, I'm going to use the Ascendia, but the step is pretty much the same for Magisk. So I'm just going to take that. And yeah, it's pretty much the same thing. So just do the same thing that I'm doing here, you do to the Magisk version of it. But what I cannot suggest is you flash both of them. That I do not suggest. Just pick one and go with it. Don't take both as it can cause some conflicts and it's going to be a pain. So that's it, and let me just go to the terminal. There, let me just make sure my device is still in sideload. Sometimes it can disconnect. And yes, I'm in sideload, as you can see here. Now I'm back here. So you need to check if it's detected. So you type ADB devices. As you can see, it's detected in sideload mode. So now you need to go back and you're going to have to change into this directory. Let me just copy the directory here. Then when you copy, you go into the terminal. Then you're going to type CD. Then you're going to paste in the directory. So now it's there in downloads A52. And now I'm there. So now what you're going to do, you need the file name. So you're just going to click rename to copy the file name with the extension. So you just click Control A. Then you copy it with the Control C. Then you go into terminal. Then you type ADB sideload. Then you paste the file name. Then you click enter. Let me just click when I have the device here so you can see what happens. Then you click enter. As you can see on the device, it's flashing and it's saying serving the KSU file. Please note this is the same thing with the Magisk, and you just do the exact same thing that I'm doing right now. And as you can see, it's done. And like I said before, it's One UI basically. That's why it's saying One UI detected, even though it's like a custom ROM. And yeah, so that's pretty much that. I'm going to reboot, then I'm going to show you how it looks like. And for Magisk, it's going to bring in the app, which you can just download basically. So the Magisk app is going to be loaded into the phone, but for the Kernel SU, you need to download the whole thing from GitHub. That's the only difference. And yeah, let me just load in. I already have the Kernel SU app on my phone, so I'm just going to see if it's now detected, because previously it was not. So let's give it a few. So now I'm going to open it, and as you can see, it's now working. And that's basically it. It's a pretty straightforward step. And it all just comes down to unlocking your bootloader, which is the process of going to settings and OEM unlock, then flashing a custom recovery. Then you go ahead to use the recovery to now flash the root, which is basically Kernel SU or Magisk. So as you can see, the Ascendia KSU kernel. This is a kernel. There's also the standalone file, but for my device, it's not available. It just comes with the kernel, which is pretty fast. And yeah, that's it. I hope you enjoyed. This was a pretty straightforward step. And now I have Kernel SU. The same step can be done for Magisk, and the only difference is how they both work, and you can just look into that on your own free time. But once again, do not install both of them, just install one or the other. So that's it. Thank you for watching and have a good one. Goodbye.